I'm GlenNeta Griffin, and welcome to CCTV's Best of Clayton 2016. We're providing a recap of our top stories, news coverage, and collaborations from the entire year. Number 10 is none other than one of our most popular collaborations of the year. The Showcase Clayton Business and Community Expo showcased over 60 exhibitors, food and drink vendors, gift drawings, business networking, and health screenings, all while featuring our Clayton County government's Show on the Road. Let's take a look.
Hi, this is Jeremy Stratton, the CEO of the Clayton County Chamber of Commerce. We're here at the Showcase Expo and Job Fair. We're very excited here. We are sold out. We have over 70 booths, which includes a lot of people that are looking for job opportunities, as well as we have a lot of vendors that are giving away food. So this has been a very good event. This is the largest one we've had. And we've had a really large crowd. We expect over 1,000 people here today.
Well, I'm so delighted to be here, as usual, for the Show on the Road. And you know, I think the best part of this is how we all come together as a county. You've got every department here. You've got the heads of departments. You've got your police. You've got all your services here. And this is a way that we make ourselves available to the community. And understand something. We're not here just because of this function and this event. We are always here. We're here to serve the community. We're here to serve you, Clayton County, and we're excited to be here. And this upcoming 2016 to 2017, there's so many new ideas and new ventures and new energy. There's new energy in our county, and we need you to be with us, to partner with us, to make sure that we keep Clayton moving forward. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for sharing this with us, and thank you for being our partner, Clayton County.
Hi, my name is Sam Waldrop. I'm with Jonesboro First Baptist Church. I'm the Director of Operations here at the Recreation Outreach Center, a great facility, and this is our pleasure to host the Clayton Expo for the seventh year, and it's just a wonderful endeavor where we try to work with the other agencies, Clayton County Government. We have 27 Clayton County Government agencies here, various vendors and food court folks like Bojangles and Carrabba's, for instance, and it's just a great combined effort between the county agencies and our church to enlighten the community on the agencies and the companies that are available in our city and our county for them. And it's just a delight to do it for the seventh straight year.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Williams. I represent Jennifer Williams State Farm Insurance Agency, located at 6233 Jonesboro Road in Morrow. Today we're here as our inaugural year of representing our agency. To be here and network and meet members of the community as well as the political people that are here in our county. So this is exciting for us. We specialize in insurance and financial services. And we, you know, make sure that whenever our clients come into us, we take the time to do an insurance and financial review to help you do a full assessment of what your needs are and cater them to you. So we at State Farm, we're always a good neighbor. We try to do our best in supporting the community as well as helping you with your insurance and financial needs.
Hi everyone, I'm Deputy Chief of Professional Standards for the Clayton County Fire and Emergency Services. This is a great event for us to attend. We enjoy meeting the public when they're not having an emergency. We like to reach out and teach about our extinguisher training. We also like to let everyone know what our hiring process is and that we're always looking for an opportunity to hire someone from within the community to serve our community. So this event is a great time for us to see everyone and also collaborate with other departments in the county.
Hey guys, my name is Brooke Waters and I'm the marketing manager for our Bojangles franchise, Trick'em Ops, doing business as Bojangles in Atlanta. And this is Damon Kopp. He'll be the general manager of the new location in Morrow. And we are so excited to be in Clayton County. We're here today at the showcase and we will be opening our new location on Jonesboro Road across from Sam's Club next to Quick Trip in October. So we hope you will all come out and get fresh chicken, made from scratch biscuits, and legendary iced tea. But we're thrilled to be here and we look forward to serving you soon.
I'm Mike, registered the chief of police for Clayton County, and this is our show on the road. Show on the road is very important for Clayton County government and the community because it gives us an opportunity to come together and for you, the community, to ask us questions. Today, it's been a great event, had a lot of interaction with the community, and that's a great thing because that partnership is the most important thing, especially from a law enforcement perspective.
Hi, my name is Kimberly McCall. I'm with Atlanta Gastroenterology Associates, and we are very excited to be here. This is our first year here. The main thing that our physicians do is screen for colon cancer. They do colonoscopies. We also deal with your digestive tract. So I like to tell people anything going in your mouth, out your bottom, is what our physicians deal with. And we also have a pediatric division if you have little ones that are infant to 18.
Hello, my name is Tim Duncan. I'm Director of Athletics at Clayton State University. We're participating in the Clayton County Chamber Expo, and this is our second time, and we're totally excited. We have our booth here. We have information about our teams, and most importantly, we have members of our men's basketball team who should be here any moment, and they'll be volunteering, helping serve in the community. That's something that we really enjoy doing, is serving the community, and members of our men's basketball team are here doing that today, so hopefully you'll get a chance to meet them later.
Dietrich Stanford, Chief Operating Officer, Clayton County Board of Commissioners. Again, we're just excited about another year with the Chamber and the Community Expo. This is a great opportunity in partnering with our public-private relationships as well as county government overall. It's a great opportunity for our citizens to come out and get involved in all the happenings within Clayton County. And again, we look at it as really as a successful partnership.
My name is Horace Bernard Franks. I work with Clayton County Water Authority now 20 years. I'm Assistant General Manager over Operations. So again, I represent Clayton County Water Authority. And we are so proud of our utility. We're an award-winning facility. We win awards every year for the quality of our water and for our service as well. Now what you have before you is we're giving out bottles that we're putting some of our own water in, which we call a program Tap on the Go. We're encouraging all of our customers and, of course, all of our neighbors to drink tap water. It's the safest thing you can drink, and the quality is high, you know, compared to bottled water. That's a competition, but we know we won't completely win that. We want to encourage you to take full use of your water because of the quality of it.
My name is Jimmy Link. I'm the head men's basketball coach here in Clayton State University. Our whole team is here representing our program and community service. This is our second year here, and we think this is a great event for us and for the county and for our school and the program.
So this is my first time here at the Clayton County Showcase Expo, and for so far, I like the atmosphere. They have great people, a lot of good business. Haven't tried the food yet, but I want to. And good around great people and making my way around.
On to number nine. The Clayton County Police Department officially rolled out the new bike patrol units. These officers are not only fully equipped as any other officer, but they actually volunteered to man the new unit. Clayton County citizens now have additional security as they enjoy our parks and trails. Let's check it out.
Excited about this new venture that the police department is going to do with the bike patrol.
Well, this is our new bike program, and I think we're all excited. I know that the department's excited, the community's excited.
Bikes give you more mobility, and like I said, you know, when officers are in the vehicles, it sometimes just being in the vehicle, it makes them unapproachable or seen, or the perception that they're unapproachable. On a bike, they have a better opportunity to engage with the community. They have a better opportunity to respond to certain areas a lot quicker than a patrol vehicle could. I think it's going to, as I said, impact crime, but I think that it is just another tool that we're going to use to ensure that the community feels like we're doing all that we can do to not only partner with them, but to improve their safety and quality of life.
You know, with the expansion of our pathway trails, adding this bike patrol will give the citizens of Clayton County extra protection. You know, we dedicate a lot to this community. The citizens of Clayton County truly need and deserve to feel protected.
Just appreciate all the support that the community and Clayton County government officials give us, because that gives us the opportunity to do initiatives like this.
The premier college tennis experience, hosted by Clayton County Commissioner Sona Singleton Gregory and Clayton County Parks and Recreation, presented the 2016 National HBCU Tennis Tournament, Step Show, and College Fair. Here's number 8. At number 7, Commissioner Shayna M. Rooks hosted the Back to School Bonanza and STEM Fair, offering the community inflatables, live entertainment, games, vendors, food, and let's not forget, school supplies.
Commissioner Shayna Rooks. I proudly represent District 3 of Clayton County, and today we had our first STEM Fair and Back to School Bonanza. So why is STEM important? Science, technology, engineering, and math is the way of the future. We need to educate our kids about science, technology, engineering, and math fields so they're prepared for the future. I myself am an attorney. I didn't have this education when I was younger. Perhaps had I had it, I might have had a different change of field. However, the kids learned so much today, and as a reward, 300 backpacks and lunch boxes. So we want to thank all of our sponsors who were here with us today and who allowed us to be able to donate and give these backpacks and lunch boxes to these kids in Clayton County. They learned so much. So thank you, thank you, thank you.
Now, if you like live music on the green, then you would have loved the Sippin' Sounds Summer Concert Series. Clayton County International Park welcomed thousands of citizens and beyond to our very own Lakeview Amphitheater. And trust me, these amazing artists had all of Clayton County up and out of their seats. Here's number 6. number 5 is no surprise. All I have to say is, our seniors really know how to party.
Nutrition for the community of seniors, and we look forward to the event growing and becoming better and better each year.
Second year coming to Mayfest. As last year, it was very enjoyable. We won prizes. This year is just as enjoyable. We're having a ball.
My name is your state senator, Valencia C., serving Senate District 34. I am so happy to be a part of Mayfest 2016. I am so proud to be 60 plus, and I'm so proud to be a part of Mayfest right here in Clayton County, Georgia.
My name is Deputy Chief Hawkins, and I'm with the Clayton County Police Department, and I am always excited about Mayfest. This is one of the events that Clayton County produces on every year, and it's so exciting just to be around all the wisdom, just to be inside all the dancing, see how lively they are. So it's always a fun event to be at every single year. I'm here all day hanging out and having fun.
Commissioner Gail Hambrick's Back to School Bash at Flat Shoals Park rocked the north side. Let's take a look at number 4.
Susie Griffin. I've been in this area for 40 years, and I'm having a ball today with my grandkids and my family.
Hey, my name is Victor, and it's been a blast down here just hanging out. It's really fun, hot dogs, hamburgers. It's been the funnest time of life. Come down, get your free stuff.
Hey, my name is Kamora Jennings, and I think that the school bash is very awesome for my first year. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Renly Nurse, and this is my first year at the Back to School Bash, and I think it's great. I have a young one who's going into kindergarten. She's five, so it's awesome to be able to have these supplies for my daughter. And I think it's awesome. The festivities, I hate the food and everything. I think it's great, man. I hope it gets bigger and bigger each year.
At number three, the Clayton County Board of Commissioners hosted the ribbon-cutting ceremonies, not only for the new Sector 2 Police Precinct, but also the highly anticipated Animal Control and Adoption Center. Here's a great opportunity to see your tax dollars at work.
Facility that we're opening today is the Animal Control and Kennel Facility. It is a state-of-the-art facility that includes surgical suites, holding areas, bonding areas for the dogs. The focus here is on adoption of animals. It sits on a 21-acre site that Clayton County has acquired.
We believe that we needed a better facility to care for the animals, and today we celebrate this accomplishment.
This is something to come have fun with. We encourage folks to come adopt. Obviously, we want you to come adopt. But the other thing is, just stop by to say hey.
As you can see, it is a beautiful facility. Looking forward to great things coming out of this facility, such as many dogs as possible being rescued.
It is a great day. And I am happy, as the chairman said, to finally have this building completed. It's been quite a journey.
State's very own Lakers basketball games are now airing, drum roll please, right here on CCTV. That's right, Tuesday nights at 10 p.m. Check them out. Here's number two. Clayton County citizen and super centenarian Maggie Katie Brown Kidd turned 112. She is not only the oldest living Georgian, but now has been designated as the oldest living African American in the United States. Here's number one.
Today we honor the extraordinary life of Maggie Brown Kidd by publicly recognizing her contributions to the community. She is recognized as the oldest living African American in the United States. And whereas Ms. Maggie Brown has demonstrated demonstrated how long a life can be lived and enjoyed.
It's a joy to be in the presence of someone that's done so much in such a long period of time. And I just want to let you know, being raised by my grandmother, it means a lot to see someone full of life bringing such great joy to the county this particular day. So just for me personally, as the Chief Operating Officer, I want to let you know personally, thank you for all that you do and you continue to do for this county and this country, and God bless you.
Now here I lay my eyes on a woman that's 112 years old. There's a lot that God has allowed our eyes to see. And we can only pray that he would be gracious enough to give us this lifelong legacy that Miss Kitty has obviously proven to us that it's possible.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
This has been CCTV's Best of Clayton 2016. I'm your host, GlenNeta Griffin. Thank you for joining me.